CP the franchise, NBA analyst. CP, I want to start you with this question. KnicksFanTV, ready? But also overall basketball analyst. CP, I want to start you with this question. Ready? First of all, how you been? I haven't seen you in a minute.
How have you been? Is vacation finally over? You know, I'm looking for you.
Just starting.
Raj is, you know, he's city hopping all over the world, watching soccer games. You're MIA. I mean, me and Brendan, we're getting ready to start up our own thing on the Max Kellerman
Show. Yeah, that would
be
very, very widely listened to. Listen, so what I want to ask you about is this. Yeah. I see Trae Young play. Dude, that looks like a top 10 player to me. He's putting a team on his back, and he's making a deep playoff run. I see Donovan Mitchell play. Second year in a row when he's on the court. That's a top 10 player, right? I see Devin Booker play. Holy Lord, this kid can play. How are the... Yeah. But then check this out. Just listen to these names, okay? LeBron, KD, Kawhi, Steph, Harden, AD, Embiid, Luka, Jokic, Giannis. That's 10. Yeah. Oh, that what? So like guys like Paul George, they're not top 15 players anymore. Cause dude, there's Trey, Booker, Donovan Mitchell, CP3, Kyrie, Westbrook, Bradley Beal, Paul George. What is happening in the NBA? Is there a changing of the guard taking place before our eyes?
There is. And what we're seeing is we're seeing the present and the future superstars of the NBA, especially with LeBron James on his way out. What we saw last night from Trae Young was nothing short of magical, Max. I saw him live for the first four games of the Knicks series. He was incredible. You know, the late, great Kobe Bryant once said about Steph Curry, he said, "How do you guard a player who's comfortable taking the shots that the defense wants him to take?" And that's what we saw from Trae Young last night. There is no answer for him. He once said that Jrue Holiday was the toughest defender he's ever faced. Well, he cooked Jrue Holiday last night, and he cooked the Bucks defense last night. An absolute maestro out of the high pick and roll. As soon as he turns that corner, he's a triple threat, whether it's the floater, whether it's the lob over the top, or getting it out to one of many three-point shooters. The kid is absolutely phenomenal, man. Now his third straight road victory in the first game of the playoffs. He stole the game against the Knicks. He dominated Philadelphia, and now he dominated the Bucks.
As was
absolutely
pointed out,
incredible.
CP, the franchise on the Max Kellerman Show, ESPN Radio. As was pointed out during the broadcast last night, Brooke Lopez is unplayable because of Trae Young's pick and roll. And I can't even blame Jrue Holiday. Like, he's getting no help. And Kenny Smith broke it down at one point. He and Shaq started arguing, but he broke it down. Like, no defender can stop Trae Young one-on-one. Jrue Holiday can do the best possible job, but you're going to need some help. He has been absolutely phenomenal. But CP, so has Devin Booker when he's been on the floor.
Yeah.
So was Donovan Mitchell. So let's expand the 10 to 12. Let's see let's say the top 10 slots, unless you disagree, are some order of LeBron, KD, Steph, Harden, Kawhi, AD, Embiid, Jokic, Luka, and Giannis. Okay, like those top, it's hard to take one of those guys off. So there are two more slots for the top 12. So here are your candidates, as far as I'm concerned. You could add anyone you want. Donovan Mitchell, Devin Booker, Trae Young, CP3, Kyrie Irving, Bradley Beal, Russell Westbrook, Paul George. I'm not even getting to, like, there are lots of dudes I'm leaving off now. Who rounds out the dirty dozen? You got two more slots. Pick them.
Two more?
Yep.
Man, oh man.
888.
I have to go ESPN. I have to go Spider for sure.
Okay. Ooh, before you reveal. Spider's on for sure, there's one more slot. Is it gonna be Trae Young, Devin Booker, Chris Paul, Kyrie Irving, Bradley Beal? Who gets the 12th slot?
At this level of play, I have to give it to Trae Young, not just for his scoring ability, but listen, Max, this guy finished second in the league in passing. He's a playmaker. We cannot forget that. Yep. So he is truly a dynamic threat out there, and I have to give that to him. Over Book. Book has been great. He's been great in the playoffs and certainly on the rise. He's a superstar himself. But Trae Young's playmaking ability, he's playing a lot more under control in this season as compared to seasons past. And he's also, you know, dynamic up from three, dynamic on the perimeter. He's a triple threat.
I think I agree with you. It's a really tough call, but just understand what you're saying. What you just said, means Chris Paul is not a top 12 player in the league. Kyrie Irving is not a top 12 player in the league. Neither is Devin Booker. I mean, are those the next three in? Are those three guys the next three in? And that rounds up the top 15. So no Paul George, no Bradley Beal, no Russell Westbrook.
I'm not putting in Beal. He's too one-dimensional. Great scorer. One of the best in the league. No doubt about it. One-dimensional. CP3, he's still at the top, but he's more of a leader now. You know, the numbers is not going to strike out at you. You know what I mean? He's still a leader. He's still floor general out there, an extension of the coach. You got to give CP3's respect. Big game for him tonight.
Oh, you know who I left out?
Paul George, I'm leaving off the list.
You know who I left out? I have to redo it. Damian Lillard.
Damian Lillard. I had Dame.
Dame's not top 10. Is he top 10?
Yeah, I put Dame in my top 10.
So who's out of your top 10?
All right, here's the top 10 I had. I had KD, LeBron, Harden, the Greek Freak, Dame, Jokic, Luka Doncic, Steph, and Kawhi Leonard.
So you don't I think Spider-Man. Embiid. Embiid was going to be MVP this year, but missed a few too many games. He was about to be MVP.
He was. I had to put the real MVP. I had to put Jokic in there.
But only because, like, he was better than Jokic. He didn't play as many games. He's the best two-way player in the game right now, you could argue, Embiid. He's not in your top 10.
I got to give playmaking an edge, Max.
What about Jason Tatum?
Tatum's in the top 15, definitely.
So if Embiid's 11, he ain't lower than 11, right? You can't. I mean, he's really top 10, but okay, you're going to put him 11. Yeah. Now you're talking. Do you see what's going on in the NBA, people? You're going
to problems to have, man.
It sounds to me like Chris Paul and either Chris Paul, Devin Booker, or Kyrie Irving are not in your top 15. 888-SAY-ESPN, 729-3776. What's Trae Young's ceiling, CP?
At this pace, Max, and I'm factoring in the playmaking because the scoring is always going to be there. You know, he had that reputation coming out of Oklahoma, but his facilitating ability as well, he could end up being one of the best point guards of all time. No doubt about it. If you're going to have this type of scoring arsenal and combine that with the fact that you're also a playmaker, I mean, the alley-oop off the glass in the third quarter of last night's game to John Collins was absolutely incredible.
The Harlem Globetrotter shot.
Yeah. I mean, the kid is fearless. He's a leader. He's cold-blooded. He could be, if he maintains at this pace, he truly could be one of the greats.
Look, Steph is better than Trae in every way until it matters most. Steph shimmies in the regular season. Trae shimmies in the playoffs.
In the playoffs.
And you would rather have the guy who shimmies in the playoffs because he just did something big.
CP, there's the no franchise. Lead safe there's when no this kid is safe. On the court. No lead is safe.
CP, there you have it. He was very, very hard on Joel Embiid, who he says is not a top 10 player. Called him a bum. That's messed up. Doesn't have CP3 in his top 15. Just ruthless today, CP. Really ruthless. All right. Listen, there he is.
It's a good problem to have.
It's a good problem to have. CP the franchise on the Goodyear hotline. Check him out. KnicksFanTV. Knicks are doing great in the playoffs right now. They're not in the playoffs right now.
So the Lakers, the Nets, and the Mavs. So the Lakers, the Nets, and the Mavs.
You're
scrambling looking for a new team now, Max. You're scrambling looking for a new team.